Hello everyone. Today we discuss about the various methods to for the disposal of the waste management. How we can dispose the various types of waste which we have discussed earlier for the safe methods so that it is not giving us any problem. Now depending upon that category, we can classify that into various parts. Let's see. Now the very first method of safe disposal of the waste is called as segregation. Segregation is the separating of waste into three categories, that is reusable, degradable and non-biodegradable. First is reusable. Reusable waste is such as paper. All the paper of the discarded exercise books, newspapers, magazines, all this paper they are all reused to form the parts. Even the toys, or which is having the metallic components, that is used for the recycling part. Second is degradable. Now this degradable waste is organic waste such as the vegetable and the fruit peeling, which can be decomposed to form manure, and this is used with the help of activities of microorganisms. Then we come to non-biodegradable. This is having certain plastics which is usually dumped into the landfills. Then we come to dumping. Dumping is the non-biodegradable waste which is put in certain places very away from the human habitations, and they are dumped into special deep pits which is dumped away from the land areas. Then we come to composting. Composting means the organic waste is put into decay which is forming manure for the agriculture land. Now how this compost is made? A trench is made out of 5 meter long, 1.5 meter wide and 1.5 meter deep. Then it is mixed with the refuse and the waste, and this is wet with the watery mixture of cow dung and the mud, and then its second layer of the refuse is put over it, and when it is reaching to the height of half a meter, then it is set up as such for 3 months, and then it is again opened and it is again rearranged in the certain areas of heaps, and then it is again covered by air, the earth, and when after 3 months it is again opened, and that is forming compost, and that compost is forming a manure which is very rich in nitrogenous matter, and that is used. Now for the latest method of this is dry composting toilets which is used. Then we come to drainage. Drainage is the proper system of drains is required to carry the liquid waste from homes, and that is other than the sewage. Yes. Now if this watery fluid is allowed to accumulate in the pits and puddles, and that will be acting as, it will serve as the breeding places for mosquitoes and other insects. Then we come to the treatment of effluent material. Now this effluent is the liquid waste which is given out from the industries. That liquid waste is called as effluent. Now for this effluent we have treatment plants for this. Now in the special treatment plants, before disposing that liquid waste of industries having harmful minerals in it, it is into the water bodies, it is done in 3 stages: primary treatment, secondary treatment and tertiary treatment. Now we talk about primary treatment. So this large debris is separated in sedimentation with the help of sedimentation process in special tanks. Then the secondary treatment is done. This waste water is dumped into the oxidation ponds where the microorganisms such as bacteria and algae is put. They oxidize that organic material, they produce carbon dioxide, and the solid material waste is, that is called as sludge, that is used as manure. And after the secondary treatment, the tertiary treatment is removing the organic waste, that is the dissolved chemicals and the pathogens, and the water which is used as such, that is used for irrigation purposes. Now then we come to incineration. Incineration is the disposable of waste by burning. Now this is serving a very large purpose. Very first, it reduces the volume of the waste, then it reduces the weight of the waste also, and then the toxic waste is converted into less toxic waste. But this is giving out very harmful, or it is giving out the fumes, harmful substances into the air. Now what precautions we could take into account for carrying out this process? It is carried out very high temperatures, it should be having pollution control devices, and it should be taken away from, and this incineration process, the special plants should be carried, they should be installed away from the residential areas. Fine. So what are the advantages for this? Because the ash which is formed after this is having, it occupies very less of space, and this can be used to cover the from this ash we can cover some materials also. Then last of all, the we covered come to this scrubbers. Scrubbers we talk about, this scrubbers is used for the separation of the gaseous and the particulate matter from the air. So this air which is passed through the dry or wet packing material, and this scrubber is giving out the dust free clean air which is removing the gaseous pollutants from air. Then last of all we come to electrostatic precipitators. Now from this electrostatic precipitator, the dirty air which is having the particulate matter is passed through the chamber which is having electrically charged plates. So through this plates, when it is passed, the dirt gets accumulated on the plates of the opposite charge and the clean air is passed out. And this electrostatic precipitators can remove maximum of 90% of the particulate matter from the air, and the free dust free air is given into the atmosphere. Thank you so much.